Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss the problem C from the latest Code Forces RAF round 1, problem name ABBB. So as you can see, there is a string and which consists of A and B characters only, and then you can remove either AB or BA from this string, and you will keep on doing this and subtract this from string and you will get the smallest string possible. So that's the whole question. As you can see in this, if you are given the string, you can choose AB, subtract this from this whole string, and the rest of the string is AABB. Then you can choose again BB, subtract this, and the left string is A. So you can choose either AB or BB from this whole string and subtract it down and then concatenate it. So in always such type of problem, only one thing strike off my mind, which is stacks. Because see, stack is the simple data structure you can use in such thing, because in this you will remove out some part and then the rest of the thing drops on that thing. What I mean by this is, like, you have some things, then you have to take out this part such that the rest of the total part will fall off this on this part. So you can do this easily using stacks. So now how you can do this, I'll show you with this example. I can copy down this example. See, this is AB and BB. So what you can do, you can make a stack. If it is empty, put the first character here. Whenever there is, so as you can see, it is either AB or BB. So you have either B in the end always, but the first character can be A or B. Okay. So now what you can do here is, you can see that, okay, it is A, so don't do anything. Now you have B. So if you have B, which means that if the top of the stack is either A or B, then I can delete it. So what I can do, I can check that, okay, now I have B, I am on this point, whether the top of the stack is A or B, yet it is A. So I will delete down this point, and I will not, because if I delete down, this means that I am removing this part. So I will move my B to this point. Now again, I will take my B, and I will check with this top of the stack, because this is removed, now this is the top of the stack. So whether this is B, so this is A, yes, so I will remove down this. If I remove down this, then okay, now I am to this. Now because this stack is empty, I have to push it, because you cannot like compare it with anything, the stack is empty. Now there is A, so you don't have to do anything. Now there is again B. So for B, I've always told you that I have to check with the top of the stack. So for the top of the stack, it is A, so you remove this. So then you come to this point, you check with the top of the stack, you delete this. Then there's two B's. So then there is again B, you'll push back this B. Then you come to the last point, you again see B, and to check at the top of the stack, it's B, so you'll delete this. And the answer is, there's nothing in the stack, the answer is 0, as you can see. So it's just a simple greedy with a stack. You know, you don't have to like think over it's very hard. It's just simple, you have to take pushing in the characters every time. Whenever you see a B, you'll check that, okay, if it's a B, then you just pop out the top element, and then you don't have to push this again. Else if the stack is empty, you have to push it, and if it is A, you have to again push it. And that's the whole logic for this problem. I'll show you. This is a stack of characters. If the stack is empty, T is, if its size is 0, it's empty, then you just have to push it, T dot push S of I. Else if S of I on which we are is B, and you don't have to check it because the other is always B or A, because if it is B, then the other will be already like B or A. You don't have any choice. So you can also delete this out, but if the S of I is B and that S, that T dot top is A or B, then we just have to pop out the top of the stack. Else if you are not popping out, you have to push it in the stack. So you can also reduce on this. If it is a B, you have to always pop it out. If it is a A, you have to always insert it. And if the stack is empty, you have to always insert. So that can also be reduced on this code. And the answer is just the size of the stack in there. So I hope you get this point of this logic also. If you still haven't mentioned now, thank you for watching this video. Also nice. Keep coding. Bye.